The idea is that there's no such thing as a true repeat.
Okay.
That's a choice. You see, perhaps part of what's happening here is that you might be using terminology that's a bit out of date.
Okay.
So the idea is that these old-fashioned ways of describing things don't necessarily represent what's really going on in the mechanism. So the concept of service to self, service to others, is understood in a couple of ways. If you want to talk about that as a split, that's fine, but it's really just a perspective. Those that value service to self above service to others, in a sense, are choosing a more negative way of experiencing the idea because they are creating a segregational energy. Those that value the idea of service to others will understand the same idea from a more positive direction because they look at it as a whole system and already realize that service to others is service to self because you can't be left out of a whole system. Whereas those that experience the idea or perceive the idea or identify the idea as service to self first in a negative way are not seeing themselves as part of a whole. They're looking at it in a segregated component sort of orientation. Now, it doesn't mean that it's not important to focus on being your true self. That's not the same thing, because being your true self first is what actually allows you to be of service to others. Because if you're not you, how can you help anybody? So there's a couple of different ways of looking at this concept, some of which are a little bit more aligned with the negative idea, some of which are a little bit more aligned with the positive idea. But it's really about looking at whole systems as opposed to breaking things apart into components.